beautiful city in the lofty Andes. Capital of Ecuador, the days begin at early dawn with the silent and diligent activity of its street sweepers. Quito was built on the ruins of the prehistoric city of the Shiri, birthplace of Atahualpa, the last Inca emperor. Since its Spanish foundation in 1534, it has grown to become a true metropolis, original and full of contrasts. Built amidst mountains and valleys, the city seems to rise and fall and stretches linearly at the foot of the majestic Pichincha Mountain. The old city, called the historic center, is full of narrow and winding streets, arches and steep stairs, stretching over hilly ground under a magnificent blue sky. The tradition of the moons belongs to Quito, and in the words of a native poet, the moons sail over the roofs like sleeping fish that pass through the night. Spanish colonization left in Quito's inhabitants a deep religious spirit, which is reflected in the magnificence of its churches and convents, where time seems to stand still, offering a constant testimony to the past. The Church of La Compañía de Jesús, built during the 17th century, represents a true work of art of remarkable unity and harmony. Its facade of Baroque style was beautifully carved in stone quarried from the Andes Mountains. It took 43 years for the skillful hands of patient natives to transform the seemingly hard and inert matter into plastic forms of great beauty. Quito's monumental churches blend a variety of decorative styles and forms. Inside La Compañía, artistic works carved in wood and plated with gold show their maximum splendor in the main altar as well as in the pulpit, and the interior decorations where walls and columns are witness to the inspiration of the artists of the famous Quito School of Art. Here, painting and sculpturing produce complementary works of art of priceless aesthetic value. La Ronda, a beautiful and typical street of colonial Quito, is a native replica of medieval Spain and stands as a symbol of conventional romanticism. Wrought iron lanterns and balconies, fragrant and colorful flowers were in fashion. The Church of San Francisco is the first great temple built in Quito. Its majestic facade is one of the best architectural jewels in South America. San Francisco's convent is a place of deep religious gathering and where the famous Quito School of Art was born. Here, painters and sculptors produced priceless works of religious art. Statues were carved with faces and gestures of wonderful realism, full of light and color. Miguel de Santiago, Gorívar, Caspicara, Legarda were the most outstanding artists of the time. Surrounded by Doric arches and columns, a beautiful patio is found in the convent, and this is a corner of exceptional beauty filled with legend and history. This is a city of bell towers and lofty domes that rise in silent prayer towards a deep blue sky. The cathedral on Independence Square is another beautiful church. Its spacious naves, coffered ceilings, and high arches are full of works inspired by famous artists, such as Miguel de Santiago and Caspicara. The extraordinary carving of the pulpit and the valuable paintings and sculptures make this cathedral a true museum. In a special vault lie the remains of Field Marshal Sucre, victor of the Battle of Pichincha, which sealed the liberty of Ecuador. The government palace is an austere building of neoclassical style. It was built during the first days of the Republic and symbolizes the authority of the state. It has been the stage of historic events. Quito launched and made possible the famous expedition to discover the great river of the Amazons. The monument to independence marks the history of national heroism. Artistically built of marble and bronze, it represents the permanent struggle of the Ecuadorian people for their liberty. Quito's proud inhabitants have written brilliant pages in their national history. They proclaimed independence for the first time in Latin America. This is why it is a city of artists, of poets, of thinkers, of martyrs, and of heroes. The architectural characteristics of the historic center, with its churches, convents, and cloisters, include invaluable artistic treasures. Its centuries-old squares and streets, surrounded by marvelous natural landscaping, inspired UNESCO in 1978 to declare the city of San Francisco de Quito a cultural heritage of mankind. It is one of the few cities of the world to boast such an international status. The art found in Quito is not just a copy or a repetition of European religious art. Even though the Creole, mestizos, and Indian artists were instructed and taught by masters from old Europe, they knew how to instill in their works of art, timidly at first, vigorously later, the imagination of their generous land and people. This is the reason why the Baroque style of the works of art in Quito also contain designs and colors that make them distinctive. The process of independence and the start of the Republic introduced some architectural innovations in the city. Many buildings of evident neoclassical style appeared. Nevertheless, there remained certain elements that had predominated over the centuries of Spanish domination. The old central bank building, with its columns, stone steps, and facade of severe lines, offers a clear testimony of this change. This and other buildings, constructed during the same period, give slightly modern characteristics to the historic center. In order to preserve artistic, archaeological, and historical monuments, the Ecuadorian government created the National Institute of Cultural Heritage to preserve and restore this precious legacy. An old building known as the Cuartel de la Real Audiencia, which served as lodging for Spanish troops at the beginning of the past century, there is the Mena Camaño Museum, which displays wax figures in a dramatic scene depicting the death of several heroes who gave the first call for freedom in Spanish America. On the site where the Battle of the Pichincha took place on May 24th, 1822, a monument in memory of the heroes of the independence has been erected. The historic center is also a frequent stage for cultural events which keep alive the patriotic spirit and kindle the love for liberty and justice of the Ecuadorian people. From the colonial center of Old Quito, we take modern tunnels that connect us to the northern part of the city. Here we find a modern city in a matter of minutes, leaving behind churches, convents, and tradition. The Church of La Basilica marks the transition point between the old and the new. 50 years of still unfinished construction have gone into the building of this Gothic-style work of art, with its tall towers, magnificent vaults, and beautiful multicolored stained glass windows. The city begins to take a definite form and spreads to the north, where the terrain is more level. Presiding majestically over La Alameda Park is the monument to the liberator Simón Bolívar, and this is a corner where the weary can find rest and peace. Quito's unusual geographic location at 10,000 feet above sea level offers spring weather and clean, crisp atmosphere all year round. The variety of building styles in Quito's architecture at times reflects the influence of foreign cultures. The present building of the Ecuadorian Central Bank is a skillful combination of design, techniques, and material in a modern construction. Here, the Archaeological Museum gathers and displays numerous relics of Ecuador's past, from its remote origins in the Paleo-Indian period, over 12,000 years ago, to the cultural and artistic works left by the Inca period. Here we find the first silver works in the world, the oldest ceramic pieces on the American continent, as well as pieces worked in gold that attest to the high cultural level reached by these people. This museum and the galleries of art constitute a valuable contribution by the Central Bank to the conservation and diffusion of the cultural heritage of Ecuador. Quito, as the capital of the country and the seat of the government, has a variety of public buildings of different styles. Among them, the Council of the Province of Pichincha, the Legislative Palace, the National Direction of Tourism, the Department of Industry and Commerce, the Department of Agriculture, the Chamber of Industry and Commerce, the Old Nunciature, and the most important health centers, the Military Hospital and the Social Security Hospital. The Mejia National Institute of Education, of old tradition and prestige, the Central University, founded in 1826. National and foreign educational centers are offering to the young the opportunity to forge their dreams and keep alive their hope for a better future. The homes of Quito's inhabitants are located to the north. Their many styles, some of which show elegance and originality, are the product of the imagination of their architects. Quito is undoubtedly the center of the dynamic cultural activity of the country, the headquarters of the Ecuadorian House of Culture, named after its founder, the writer Benjamin Carrión, features permanent and significant cultural events such as recitals, art exhibitions, conferences, film festivals, theater, seminars, etc. It also maintains constant activity in its functional museums and renovated National Library. Quito is a cosmopolitan city, new and ancient at the same time. It is cozy and warm to the visitor and offers generous hospitality. Since the 50s and especially during the 60s, Quito, under the oil boom, has grown enormously, especially to the north, changing spaces and concepts of living and creating bright and lovely environments. This vision of modern Quito, with its wide and well-laid avenues, overpasses and plazas, its tall buildings emerging against the blue mountains, is the panorama of a great metropole in the midst of an incomparable landscape. Thank you. beautiful residential neighborhoods, reflecting the building trends of different periods. In them, we find why Quito is a city of contrasts, where ancient ways meet modern concepts. Sidewalk restaurants is one of the privileges of those who live in Quito or have the opportunity to visit it. Quito maintains an active international exchange with the principal cities of the world. Trade, commerce, banking, industry, as well as cultural events have established a network that brings international airlines to our city in the clouds. The extraordinary Andean landscape, with its imposing snow-capped mountains, such as the famous Cotopaxi, can be seen from any point in the city. The Ministry of Foreign Affairs is the center of contacts with countries in all five continents. It keeps diplomatic relations with almost all the nations of the world. Embassies and consulates with headquarters in Quito enjoy the generous hospitality of the city. The demands of a growing international tourism are met satisfactorily by the services of hotels with international status. Elegant and comfortable hotels, strategically located, cater to the needs of all travelers and tourists. Hotels with a variety of styles, sizes, and locations are available to satisfy the most demanding requirements. A variety of exquisite international as well as typical native dishes are offered in many restaurants of the city. Quito is becoming famous for its outstanding cuisine. In the new northern section of the town, churches of modern conception, harmonizing with the urban surroundings, have been built in the last decades. Concrete has replaced stone, and novel designs have given modern churches a structurally dynamic shape, together with a peaceful religious atmosphere. Present architectural currents have materialized in buildings and homes with new spatial distribution. Functionality and elegance harmonize with the use of advanced technology, providing a new way of life. Tall concrete buildings of glass and aluminium rise on the horizon of the modern city. Economic activities of all kinds are concentrated here. is a center of active trade. Its large shopping centers compete in elegance and sophistication and offer a wide selection of national and international goods and products. Light and color in daring combinations characterize the ultra-modern designs of these commercial centers. The long modern avenues that cross the city are signs of the city's adequate urban planning, with special emphasis on landscaping. The avenues of Quito are full of colorful gardens that are very carefully kept. Highways are modern and functional, and engineering that follows the unusual topography of the city. They provide effective traffic communication. Green parks with all kinds of opportunities for open-air entertainment bring together a population that is anxious to take advantage of their leisure time. Appropriate settings contribute to the widespread practice of sports. There is massive and enthusiastic attendance to the stadiums, where soccer, the favorite sport, awakens euphoric passions and is the cause of constant interest and comments at every social level. Boxing is another sport with many, many fans. A sport with Spanish roots, intensely colorful, attracts a public that overflows the seats of the monumental plaza, in which year after year, the Quito Fair is held. Internationally famous bullfighters participate in this festival, honoring Quito's birthday. Another old tradition of Spanish origin is kept in the cockfights. This is an event held weekly in the arena where these brave birds provide entertainment mixed with the passion of the game and the betting. This is another interesting sport of purely local development. The rough, mountainous and open terrain of Quito provides a perfect natural setting for the new sport of gliding. As they cut through space, their eyes bewitched by the colorful city below them, the brave gliders imitate the flight of the condor. The private clubs that exist in Quito have available excellent tennis courts and golf courses. The fans of these sports not only can practice them, but also have the opportunity of witnessing international contests involving world champions. Many of the type of contests are constantly taking place in Quito, such as canine shows. Open-air exhibits of all types, which put new artists directly in contact with their public, are examples of the varied events that Quito has to offer. Quito, faithful to its renowned artistic tradition, has many new art galleries the last few years. They exhibit works of art by national and foreign painters. The Guayasamin Museum is an art complex of continental prestige, comprising a museum, a gallery, and a workshop. They are directed by the famed painter of the masterpieces such as Camino de Llanto and Edad de la Ira, Osvaldo Guayasamin. The works of this creative genius are to be found in the most important museums of the world. Exhibition centers, movie theaters, and cinemas are the appropriate frame for artistic presentations of national and international character. The old National Sucre Theater offers programs by the prestigious school of the National Dance Institute. Quito's nightlife offers innumerable attractions. Circuses and bright amusement parks are the joy of children as well as adults. A variety of very elegant casinos offer tourists a chance to enjoy themselves and to try their luck. Many discotheques are flooded by the euphoria of youthful music and dancing. Folklore music is also very popular among the young people and may be heard in the picturesque Peñas. Here you can meet its very enthusiastic followers. Meanwhile, the shadows have fallen on the city and the sounds of the day whisper into darkness. The churches silently show their illuminated domes and steeples. Quito falls into the peaceful sleep of 1,000-year-old legends that are lost in the depths of time and mystery.